Whiskey Jason here, whiskey from the viewpoint of an American over here in Germany, often tasting rare and exotic whiskeys. My fourth and final top 10 video. Well, not exactly. I had the top 7 world whiskeys, the top 10 Irish whiskey, the top 10 bourbon, and now the top 10 Scotch whiskeys. These are all whiskeys that I actually tasted and gave a tasting review video of them in 2022. I took the 12 best, gave them to my super fans. I ranked them, they ranked them. The rankings were added together, and this is what you get, my top 10 list. All right, so we're going to start off here with number 10, the Glen Scotia 12-year-old seasonal release for 2021. The first time Glen Scotia did that, by the way, it was heavily charred and Oloroso casks in the finish. Whiskey base number 190979. I very much enjoyed that whiskey. Now, it was number 12 on my list, but it was number 4 on the list of my super fans. So, averages out to number 10. There were just other things I liked better, but that was a good whiskey in my opinion. I really liked that Glen Scotia seasonal release. The 2022 version was finished in Amontillado casks. Not my favorite. Didn't like that. So I do like Glen Scotia, and after being there this year, in May of 2022, I was in Campbelltown, went to Glen Scotia. Really love to learn to love that distillery and their products. It's a good distillery. Good. Number 9, surprising for me, Glenallachie Ruby Port Wine Wood Finish, a 12-year-old, whiskey base 192598. Billy Walker brought out a sherry, I think that was 10 years or 11, and then there was a 12-year-old Ruby Port. Port should be towny if it was in a wood cask longer. Ruby ports are usually seasoned cask, yet for some reason, Port and Glenallachie seem to have actually worked out very nicely together. So Glenallachie is doing good things in my the way I consider it, anyways. Look forward to seeing Glenallachie maybe being sold in the next 2 years. Who knows? So remember, how long did Billy Walker have Glendronach? About the same amount of time he now has had Glenallachie. All right, so conspiracy theory. Number 8, Glencadam, 11-year-old, single cask of Germany, number 1299. It's in 2010 to 2021 cask strength bourbon maturation, whiskey base number 197780. Beautiful bottle. I bought a second one. A couple times I've gone back to this, tried it again, and just go, oh, the perfection of Glencadam in cask strength in a good first fill bourbon barrel. Wonderful. Could it have been older? But I really liked it, and I bought a second bottle, so that means a lot for me. All right, so now number 7, something that was very recent. I don't even think it's on my German channel. I don't even think it's on my English channel yet. It's been filmed. It's been broadcast in Germany, and it's the Glenrothes 16-year-old sherry butt from Douglas Lang, German exclusive, fanatical about flavor, whiskey base number 222678. 16 years full maturation in a sherry butt, 2006 distilled, 2022 bottled. This was a fabulous whiskey. I don't know about you, but sometimes sherry whiskeys or sherried whiskeys can have a little bit of that syrupy, a little bit of that yucky plastic moment going on there, especially with very young seasoning casks. This was a 16-year-old full maturation in that sherry butt. This was old school whiskey. This is so good. I thoroughly enjoyed it. A single cask for Germany. My video should have came out this week. Will probably be next week. Sorry. You'll find out about it in a moment. So I'm using exactly the same list I did with my German channel. Sorry. All right. So number 6, Glengarry. Glengarry spelled all together with a lowercase g for Geary, a 9-year-old. It was a Duncan Taylor Octave for Kirsch exclusive. So we're getting a lot of good German exclusive bottlings from different distilleries due to Kirsch. Love you. Love that a lot. This was whiskey base number 203098. This was something I just bought because it was on their website. I'm registered as a with their wholesaler site, where I, as a online shop, can buy things and sell things. And I was just, okay, good. I'm Glengarry is one of these distilleries that I predict that will blow up in the next year or two, as in not explode, but actually become a big thing. Yeah, I think Beam Suntory has invested so much in getting everything right at Glengarry that we, the geeks, should start actually not just even noticing Glengarry, but actually start praising Glengarry and buying that. So I expect that Glengarry is going to be in 2024 at the latest, they're going to have some big hits out there for us coming. And that 9-year-old octave finish was just perfection. I mentioned it, a couple people bought a bottle and wrote back to Jason, you're so right. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of the octaves, but that was very, very good. All right, number five. And I must admit that I have been, I just never thought about doing a video about this bottle, the Tullibardine the Murray. 2008, 2021, the Marquis Collection, whiskey base number 9197803. This is a excellent, excellent bottle. Great packaging, great taste, cask strength, bourbon cask. Tullibardine, I've actually somehow omitted from my videos for many, many, many years. I don't know why. I visited them once. I was going up to Speyside. They closed at 5. I was there at 4:30. She showed me a little bit around. Wasn't able to join the tour that was going on. Very nice people. I would have loved to have seen the cooperage. I think Tullibardine is also one of those hidden gems of Ireland, of Scotland at the moment. All right. So now number four. I personally was surprised myself that I put this on my top 10 list, and that I went back and watched the video. And I watched back another video where I compared this to other stuff, and I was like, this is so good. Bunahabin Fashil 2022. And now, how do I pronounce this correctly? Achrein Arik. My Gaelic is non-existent, sorry. Whiskey base number 203498. I tasted this at the distillery for the first time. I was there before Fashil. But they actually had that little set, and I was able to try it, bought the set, brought it home, did a video about it, and then I actually had bought warehouse bottlings. It was a little 0.2 bottles, I think. I had a port, I had a wine, I had four different ones, and I added then this bottle and compared it to everything else. Blew everything out of the water. That Pedro Jimenez, that PX cask at the end here of this Buda was so good. My top four. Well done. All right. So now, in my German videos, if you've ever watched them, you probably can't because you don't speak the language. I understand. I've been doing these top 10 lists now for 6 years, I think. This is gonna be the sixth year, the first year in English for me. And almost the last three, I think twice, old Glendronach was one, or even second place. Now, this year, Glendronach, a 27-year-old from 1993, and Olle Rose Sherry Puncheon number 7274, cost €450, I think. Whiskey base number 192739 is only third position. And not just I gave it the third position, but also my super fans. And that shows me the quality of the whiskeys in number one and number two. All right, so you often, not always, but you often get what you pay for. Glendronach, 1993, 27 years old. It was heavenly. Nothing to complain about. Wonderful, yummy. A little bit on the expensive side, but absolutely something that you can write home about, okay? So, which means the next two whiskeys are even better. Is that possible? Yes. Both I and my super fans both agreed. Now, I have a different whiskey for number one. They have the second one as the first one, but I can imagine why. All right, so what is the number two whiskey on my list of the best single malt scotch in 2022? It is at least over in Germany, there's consensus. Bunehagen 12-year-old cask strength 2021 edition 55.1%. Whiskey base number 194125. Now, why isn't the 2022 version? Because I haven't tried it yet. The 2022 version just came out for me in Germany at the middle of January. I actually have a bottle of the 2022 and a bottle of the 2021, and I did a bottle share with both. So each person gets actually 5 cl of the Buna 2021 and the Buna 2022 cask strength, and they get to try that and compare the two of them. I did that on Christmas Eve. I have a group of people called Superfans. They support me on Patreon and YouTube with at least €1 a month or €2. And so they get the privilege of actually taking part in my bottle shares an hour earlier than everyone else. And this set of the Buna 12 cask strength 2021-22 was sold out within minutes. It's going to be so fantastic. I love the 2021. I thought the Buna 12 2021 was better than a 27-year-old Glendronach. Yeah. Price, €85, give or take. A good price for what you're getting, all right? So what's then my number one? Now, there's one whiskey this year that is one of those, it stuck out of my head. It was like the perfect whiskey ever made. And that is an Edredauer 22-year-old Oloroso Sherry Finish. From 1999 up until 2021, whiskey base number 196985. Now, this bottle runs at about 300 plus euros. It's expensive, but I tried it and it was just perfection. I've gone back, I've used that bottle a few times now to compare other things. Nothing comes close, at least in my opinion. All right, so there has been a few different Edredauers sherry cask finish, but this was from 1999 until 2021. And make sure you get the right whiskey base number. Oh, heavenly, heavenly, my number one without thinking about it. Now, Buna 12 is going to be, at least for half of the YouTubers I know over here in Europe, going to be their number one. And for me, it was very good, but the Edredauer was better. Yeah. We've had some good whiskey this year. At least I have had some good whiskey this year over here in Germany. All right, let's go back very briefly so you see them here. Number 10 is going to be the Glen Scotia 12 seasonal release 2021. Number 9, the Glen Allachy Ruby Port Wood Finish, 12 years of age. Number 8 is the Glen Caddam Single Cask for Kirsch, 11 years of age. Number 7 is going to be brand new bottling from Glen Rothes. Over here for Germany exclusive, fanatical about flavor, 16-year-old sherry butt, full maturation, yum. So number 6 is Glengarry, a Duncan Taylor Octave for Germany exclusive, just 9 years of age. Number 5 is Tully Badin the Murray, shh, don't tell others, it's a great whiskey at a great price. The Marquet collection. Number 4, Buna Fashil Ail, Achen. Arik, don't know how to pronounce it. Number 3, Glendronach, 27-year-old from 1993 on Oloroso Sherry Punch, and wow. So number 2, Buna 12 cask strength from 2021, yeah. And the best one ever, at least this year, was my Edredauer 22-year-old Oloroso Sherry Finish from 1999. Very, very good stuff. Now, the question of the day is for you. What was your favorite, your best Scotch whiskey of 2022? Do we have any overlapping, totally different? Now, one thing you will notice, there's not a single peated whiskey on this list. Why not? Because I'm not a peat head. I was on Islay this year. I visited all of the open distilleries. The only one that wasn't, I did not visit, was Coila. At every place I tried to do a warehouse tasting, I invested literally thousands of euros to get there for the hotel, for the food, for the warehouse tastings, for everything. I came home, still not a peathead. I appreciate what they're doing in Islay. I love Lagavulin as a distillery, looking at it out from the ruins and the castles. Beautiful, 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 beautiful location. Great stuff, but not my style of whiskey. Peat is not my friend. And therefore, you'll have zero peated whiskeys here on this list, at least this year. So that's the reason why. So other people will have other whiskeys that they instead choose, prefer, and will have on the list. Put yours down below. I would love to see what they are. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for subscribing. Thank you very much for commenting, for the interaction we've had. I've had actually just this week, two different people contact me and say, I have been watching your videos for years. Thank you. And now I am in Germany. I would like to contact you and maybe we can. It's like, wow. They started to contact me, one from the UK, one from America, and they're both now in Germany. And that connection can happen. So I just love the power of the internet. I just love YouTube. I just love this interaction that we can have to be part of the Whiskey Tube community. So thank you very much and see you very, very, very soon. I wish you a very happy 2023. I hope, first of all, that you have very, very, that you have the time and take the time for good relationships. Friends, family, they cannot be replaced by money or anything else. Number two, I hope you are healthy in this year, that you can continue to drink and enjoy the whiskey that we love. And number three, I hope you set yourself some goals and you reach those goals in this year, that you have a success as you define it. Time for family and friend. Take care of your health and have success by reaching the goals that are important for you. Thank you very much. Whiskey Jason here. Bye bye.